I call this piece...
Go fuck yourself, you little bitch.
Now I know what you're thinking. Who's this well-groomed, thick-eyebrowed, and why is he on my feed? Well, fortunately for everyone, I don't have a prejudice against women. I'm talking to the inner bitch inside of me. You see, even though this last year sucked, it enabled me to have a better understanding of myself and my relationship with emotions, such as fear. You see, I see, they see. But who sees internally? There's no way of completely avoiding this primitive human emotion. We all witnessed it after the first lockdown.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Guys, I need more soap.
I mean, you can't blame them. The Roni Rona was a significant threat to a large minority of us. And I'm not here to trigger people. We all know that politics aren't good for business. I mean, publicizing your political opinion online is no good for business. Because you'll alienate your colleagues or half of your potential clients. So we don't challenge the status quo. Even if the government don't make no more sense. But that's besides the point I'm trying to make. Seeing firsthand the impact of fear on society gave me massive insight on the role of fear within the boundaries of my own mind. And I couldn't help but to feel indebted to a younger version of myself, who spent a large portion of his 20s anxious and paralyzed with doubt and fear. Instead of, well, doing.
Doing these bitches like I know I should. Sir, we don't use that type of language over here. Come on, man.
642 at 649, we need to cancel this young man immediately.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
Confinement forced me to do the internal work.
I love you.
At this pace, let's face it. There's no way I was going to make it as a YouTuber with these corny-ass self-help videos. Like, dude, you're borderline miserable. Stop dishing out life advice. My channel wasn't gaining any traction, and part of the reason was because I wasn't fully expressing myself. At one point, in order to increase traffic to my YouTube, I tried to convince the little thotty inside of me to come and dance for the TikTok. What was standing in the way of me reaching my full form as a creator? Was it fear? Fear of going viral for the wrong reason? Fear of being at the receiving end of an online witch hunt? And it got me thinking. If I'm at the exact same place I am today, 10 years from now, and I never express all my ideas, I'd be hella resentful. If an algorithm was going to stop me from reaching my potential, I could live with that. Cause it's out of my control, but nothing in my control should get in the way. If I wanted to evolve as a creator, I knew exactly what I needed to do. I needed to remind myself that the best artists came from a place of struggle. Failures, rejections, and suffering were all key ingredients that paved the way for the most celebrated artists today. Eminem isn't known for a viral YouTube video where he dished out 5 tips on how to move out of a trailer park. He was chewed up and spit out and booed off stage. Before he became Iron Man, Robert Downey Jr. struggled with drug addictions and is quoted as saying that he liked the taste of metal after putting a gun in his mouth. Vincent van Gogh blasted himself at the age of 37 after years of struggling with depression. Now, I'm not trying to glorify suicide, but to make the point that pain and suffering are part of the human experience. My boy J. Cole said it best. There's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success. And perhaps what separates the pro from the amateur is the ability to continue pushing forward and creating even when life sucks. So yeah, I guess this is the message I have for the voice inside of me, trying to convince me to quit.
Go fuck yourself, little bitch.
No!